Welcome back to another episode of An Evening by the Waterhole. It was around 5 in the evening on a cloudy day by the time I reached the forest edge. One of my first sightings were some wild boars grazing. A little later, I saw a few cheetah deer at the forest edge. Occasional rumbles of thunder were scaring the peafowl. Gradually, more cheetah deer turned up for grazing on the green grass. There were plenty of bird activity as well. Suddenly, the cheetah deer were nowhere to be seen. And while I was wondering why they had disappeared, I got the answer very soon. A pack of Asiatic wild dogs, also known as dholes, had arrived on the scene. There were at least around 10 of them, with little ones as well. A little later, the shy dogs went back into the forest. The red-wattled lapwings were constantly calling whenever it felt threatened. was quite magical to hear to the constant rumble of the thunder. After a while the danger from the dogs had passed, the cheetah deer slowly started appearing again. The deer were still edgy though. At a distance, I could see a lone sambar deer grazing. The deers finally relaxed and were grazing peacefully. It was drizzling intermittently as well. A large number of wild boars had gathered by now. More cheetah deer were now coming out into the open. Also, you can hear the rutting calls of the cheetah's stags, which serve the purpose of attracting females and asserting dominance among other males. The nocturnal birds, like nightjars, had started calling. Daylight was fading and I couldn't spot any other animals. I will leave you with a couple of minutes footage to listen to the bird calls and take in the ambience.